Nicholas Manzo. Good morning, sir. Mr. Manzo.
Yep.
You have a red light violation.
Yep.
On Pleasant Valley Parkway. Do you remember this?
Well, in fact, I went and investigated four or five times. I was wrong, no question about it. I made a right-hand turn, and that's the first violation I've gotten in 72 years of driving.
Really?
Yep. Look up my record.
I'm going to look it up.
Yep.
Now, Mr. Manzo, I'll ask you a question. Monitor here indicates that you are 93 years old.
Right.
Why are you...
World War II veteran, spent 29 months in the Pacific, okay, without coming back, and came back alive.
Where were you in the Pacific?
I was in the Navy.
You were in the Navy?
Yep.
How long did you serve?
I served 3 years, 1943, February, on my 17th birthday. I joined the Navy, and I didn't come back for 3 years. And the truth of a story is, I can tell you a little story if you got a few minutes.
I want to hear it.
I joined the Navy when I was 16 years old. I went up to Federal Hill, Holy Ghost Church. I got my birth certificate. I forged it. I made myself 17 years old. And I went down to the recruiting station. I joined the Navy. Everything went fine. Until 2 weeks later, the policeman in the Navy come up and they wanted to arrest me because I forged my birth certificate. But I waited another year, and I left Mount Pleasant High School, and I went in the Navy. And I spent 3 years, 29 months in the Pacific. Every battle that was in the Pacific, I was there. I was in it.
I receive letters from people every day, yep. And I received a number of letters from veterans who actually send me checks, and the purpose for them sending me checks is to help other veterans. Now, I would really dismiss your case outright anyway. You know, I would dismiss it. And it's not gonna go on your record, but I'm not gonna have you pay anything of this. But I have a gentleman who sent me a check for $50, and he said his father was a World War II Navy veteran. And please use this to honor him and his service as a veteran. And you were a World War II Navy veteran as well. So I'm going to use this check. This is from Anthony Christensen. And Mr. Christensen is from, looks like Panhandle, Texas. Tell me about your experiences during the war.
Well, I was on board ship, a big ship. A battleship, and we were in many, many battles, many of them. The worst one I seen was Iwo Jima. That was terrible. We lost more Marines in that invasion than I think any other war outside of the Battle of the Bulge. That was the worst that's ever, you couldn't believe how bad that was.
You were there?
I was there. Yes, I was. I was in every battle in the Pacific from 1943 to 1945. We didn't miss one, not one. And they were brutal.
Well, you have been known as the greatest generation, and you were the greatest generation. And you said something earlier, Second World War brought about a sense of patriotism in this country that we have not seen since.
Right.
But there was such strong patriotism that here you were a 16-year-old boy and you wanted to go and fight for your country. So much so that you even forged a document to try to get into the service,
yep,
to go and protect the country.
And I got caught.
But you went back.
I went back a year later, right on my birthday. I joined the Navy. And within 3 or 4 months, I was out in the Pacific. My father was an immigrant, came into this country at 18 years old and couldn't get a job, but things were tough. So he joined the Army and he went into World War I. And he was there for 18 months and he survived. He came home. And that's how we became a citizen.
They should build a monument to your family between your father in World War I and right. you and all your cousins.
My uncles.
And your uncles in World War II. Unbelievable. Wow. And they all came back.
We all came back, yeah, every one of them.
I can't thank you enough for your service.
Thank you. Thank
good,
you.
Good luck.
You're welcome.
To you.
And at 93, Judge, he's got a wonderful head of hair, too. I got to commend him for that.
Well, I remember when the judge had a nice head of hair, too.
Oh, he still does. He still does.
Boy, we could bring back them old days, huh?
They were wonderful days. These are wonderful days, too, except that we don't have the sense of family and community that we had back then.
You're right.
Thank you for your service. We
You're
owe
welcome.
You a great debt of gratitude.
Thank you. You're welcome.
It's my pleasure just to be in your company.
Come on. How cool is that? If you'd like to see more cases like this one, tune into Court in Providence every weekday. Excuse me? You didn't know Court in Providence is also a TV show? Oh, wow. Your life just got substantially better. To find out what channel we're on, go to courtinprovidence.com, click on your local listings, scroll down till you find your hometown, then start doing your happy dance. That's it. Move it. Move it. Nice.
All rise and hit subscribe so you don't miss the latest viral moments like this one. Share these videos and weigh in on the cases. You be the judge. Subscribe now.